الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من أطاعه فقد رشد واهتدى ومن عصاه فقد ضل وغوى ولا يضر إلا نفسه ولن يضر الله شيئا أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this ayah of Surah An-Nahl gives a lot of emphasis upon al-adl, upon justice. Ihsan, doing good. وَإِيْتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى, giving those who are your relative if they are poor and needy. And how important it is to abstain from obscenity, from all type of vices and transgression. These are the six things which are mentioned in this ayah. But I want to emphasize upon the first one, which is al-adl. Here there is something which is known as equality in the West. Equality between so many things. And we want to explore what is the concept of equality in Islam. We don't see that the word equality, which is in Arabic al-musawat, that is used for a positive purpose. On the other hand, the word adl is used again and again. وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ فَاحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ. When you do judgment among the people, then do justice. And on the other hand, it negates al-musawat, equality, between the two things which are not equal. For example, Quran says, هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Those people who got the knowledge, are they similar to those people who got no knowledge at all? قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الْعَامَى وَالْبَصِيرُ أَمْ هَلْ تَسْتَوِي الظُّلُمَاتُ وَالنُّورُ. Tell us, a blind person and a person who can see are equal? Tell us, the darknesses and the light, are they equal? They are not equal. Even among the human beings, among the believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that some believers, they got a higher rank than the others. In Surah Al-Hadid, لَا يَسْتَوِي مِنْكُمْ مَنْ أَنْفَقَ مِنْ قَبْلِ الْفَتْحِ وَقَاتَلْ أُولَٰئِكَ أَعْظَمُ دَرَجَةً مِنَ الَّذِينَ أَنْفَقُوا مِنْ بَعْدُ وَقَاتَلُوا وَكُلًّا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. Say, that is the previous verse, لَا يَسْتَوِي مِنْكُمْ, not equal are among you, the person who spent his money before the conquest of Makkah and fought in Ijid Jihad. They are not equal to those people who spent their money after the conquest of Makkah and then they fought. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said about the first group, أُولَٰئِكَ أَعْظَمُ دَرَجَةً, they got a higher rank. Though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as far as reward is concerned, وَكُلًّا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised each group something good. So each group is going to get its reward. But those people who were with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam before the conquest of Makkah, and those people who used to spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the time of poverty, at the time of need, can they be equal to those people after seeing the conquest of Makkah and people entering into Islam in multitudes? And when they have seen that the whole Arabia has submitted to Islam,